So let's talk about the blasphemy issue in Pakistan and how serious it is. I've spoken about it, pretty much speak about it every week. I said there's a playlist that I created that is Aag Mein Ab Sab Jalenge, meaning everyone will burn in this fire, that only Pakistani government or establishment is to be blamed for. I've said it before, this law started in 1926 or something, it was legislated by the British, the Blasphemy Law 295 A and B, which carried some sort of a sentence and mostly a fine, anyone who offends a religious belief. So from 1926 until 1986, there were only 60 or 70 cases registered under blasphemy law. Then came this military dictator called General Ziaul-Haq. He added the 295C part. He added another legislation in that, another clause in that. We said, if you insult Muhammad, then you can be sentenced to death. So 1986, it went up from 1986 to 2019. There were 1,600 cases. So in the first 40 or 50 years or so, or 60 years, there were only 60 cases. In the following 40 years, there were 1,600 cases. So what happened? Did people start blaspheming more, especially when they realized that, okay, now I can be sentenced to death? Or people started taking the issue of blasphemy more seriously because the government put it in their head that, you know what, this is something we're not going to tolerate? Obviously, this is why I say legislations matter. And we should always, that is always the first step in making any change, for better or worse, legislation. So Pakistan was, the government of Pakistan made their own people, they radicalized their own people regarding this particular issue. And funnily enough, not until now, no one out of the 1,600 registered blasphemy cases, not one person has actually been sentenced to death, because it's a ludicrous law. You just can't carry it out, because if you do carry it out, then the whole, you know, then you're going to have to explain yourself to the European Union or the American Congress. Now, what are you doing? I've quoted the story before, how this couple had been rotting in Pakistani prison since 2014. And then the matter was discussed on 30th of April in the European Parliament about this couple, Shugufta and Emmanuel, two Christians who had been rotting in prison for blaspheming over WhatsApp messages between each other. So they weren't even publicizing it. And then this matter was picked up by the European Parliament in April 2019. And guess what? 30th of April, they made a speech. They said, well, this is abhorrent. We cannot tolerate this. Pakistan should be ashamed of themselves, blah, blah, blah. And by May 30th, within 1 month, they released them. That's how international pressure works, especially on a country like Pakistan, because, you know, luckily it's not a developed country. They look to the West for handouts. And in the global world, you have to rely on other countries as well. And Pakistan's human rights record is not something to be bragging about. So international pressure is important, and this is why it's important for people like me to talk about this. And we have created a playlist. Those of you, you can go to my playlist, Minorities in Pakistan. You can see all the data collected over the last 12 months or so. You can see many cases there. If you can send it to Amnesty, if you can send it to European Parliament for Human Rights or European Commission for Human Rights, and American, if you have any American senators, contacts, etc., you can send it to them. You can collect all of that. Denise is a wonderful lady who lives in Netherlands. She's been collating that data. So speaking of blasphemy and giving you a bit of a rundown, what usually happens, have a look at this. Pakistani policeman accused of killing a man who was just acquitted of blasphemy. So this happened nearly 10 days ago, 3rd of July. A Pakistani police constable has been arrested over the murder of a man who was acquitted of blasphemy charges last year. Ahmed Nawaz told Reuters that Muhammad Waqas was hacked to death on Friday in the central Pakistani district of Sadiqabad. He said the suspect, a 21-year-old man who joined the force just months ago, told investigators he killed Waqas because he had committed blasphemy. Waqas was charged in a blasphemy case in 2016, accused of sharing content online that was insulting to Prophet Muhammad. The Lahore High Court overturned the conviction in 2020, and Waqas was released from prison. He remained underground for some time, even after his release, and returned home a few weeks ago. Insulting the Prophet carries a mandatory death penalty in Pakistan, a predominantly Muslim country. While courts have pronounced death sentences for some of those convicted, Pakistan has never carried out an execution over blasphemy charges. And then it gives you the whole history of how many people have actually been killed by mobs, vigilante attacks against those who are accused of blasphemy. So have a look at this. So this guy joined the police force. He remembered this case. He had been waiting for 3 years, and then he realized, oh, this guy's been released. And then he approached him, hacked him to death. Obviously didn't care about his own career or his future, because he was looking for a ticket to heaven and a date with 72 virgins, or maybe just a date in the heaven. Again, as I said, that is only happening because Pakistani state has radicalized their own people, so much so that they're taking matters into their own hands. As I said, 1,600 plus cases. And even the lower courts actually convict these people of capital punishment, but they never carry them out. And when the matter goes to the High Court or Supreme Court, it is almost always, not almost, it's actually always overturned. And these people are acquitted. So some people have been rotting for 6, 7, 8 years. So this guy was lucky. Well, sorry for the lack of a better term. He got released within 3 years. But some, as I said, some other people have been in prison for a lot longer than that. Junaid Hafiz, a Fulbright scholar who went to forgot the name of the American university, did his master's degree in English literature, came back to Pakistan, and he started teaching English there. And then he was convicted of blasphemy. He was accused of blasphemy, and then he's been rotting in prison ever since. I think it's been 7 years, I think. Senator John Kerry wrote to, I think, last prime minister or this prime minister that please release him, but he still hasn't been released. We know a lot of other cases as well, people like Ayaz Nizami, etc. You all know the old famous story of Asia Bibi, who spent nearly 10 years in prison, and then she was released and she made her way to Canada now. So that is what happens when you radicalize your society. To help me produce more videos like these, support me on Patreon or PayPal.